Welcome, John.
Thank you.
Happy to have you here. As president of Emergent Vision, you are the right partner to talk about high-speed imaging. According to the FRAMOS market study, 60% of the users and 75% of the manufacturers assume that bandwidth over 5 gigabit per second will be relevant or very relevant in the near future.
Yeah.
The only question is USB 3.1 or GigE vision. Why Emergent Vision goes for 10 GigE?
Mainly, it's going to come down to cable length restrictions. I mean, currently, even with the USB 3.0 standard, the cameras that are being produced now, we hear a lot of people complaining about the cable length restrictions, various types of connectivity errors, and ultimately, if you have to run long cable lengths and you need fiber converters, that adds significantly to the cost of the solution. So, of course, with the 10 gig standard SFP Plus or 10G base T on RJ45, we cover your cable lengths up to even beyond 100 kilometers with the right optical fiber converters. Obviously, things get a bit more expensive for those types of applications for the transceivers, but your typical applications can run single mode fiber up to 10 kilometers, still at a very, very cost-effective manner.
Great, thank you. Which applications benefit the most from high-speed imaging, and what users can achieve with fast cameras?
Right, I mean, certainly in various types of sports applications where instant replays is required, desired, that's one of the big applications for us. Various types of stadium applications where they, with our HR series of cameras, where you have to run long runs of fiber, you know, up to, you know, in some cases running a kilometer around a stadium, that's really nothing for our solution. So, you know, as we said, we can get up to 10 kilometers on standard single mode optical transceivers with the HR line. And then there's those certainly, you know, for the 10G base T or HT line of cameras, you know, we can do up to 100 meters for those applications.
We are here at the Vision Show in Stuttgart. Mm-hmm. What is your vision highlight, and why should visitors come to your booth and explore?
Right, so I mean, we've got a new release of the new 50 megapixel CMOSIS sensor in our cameras, both in the HR and HT lines. And that's a very exciting release for us. They've obviously worked hard to improve their image qualities, and we start to see that now with this sensor. Other elements on display in our booth, the Sony 12 meg, 9 meg, 5 meg, and 2 meg sensors. So they're actually very high quality as well. So that should be a real benefit to many of our customers who are looking for the optimal image quality. We do have also on display a very, very cool synchronized application demo where we have two of HR 2000 mono cameras streaming at 250 frames per second and synchronized to sub-microsecond without the use of IEEE 1588 or switches. Really helps to reduce the overall system cost for synchronized applications that require high accuracy.
Great. How about the latest imaging trend, virtual reality, and what is your forecast for imaging in 2018?
Virtual reality is constantly evolving. We see customers coming with different applications for VR all the time, and so ultimately we're able to leverage off of our experience with past customers, very key customers, and ultimately, you know, help new customers come into the virtual reality market.
And from which industry, which applications they ask for virtual reality solutions?
Sports is a big application, and stadium applications in particular for instant replays and so forth. But ultimately, we do have a lot of customers that are also looking at arbitrary types of applications for 3D reconstruction. Could be of human subjects, could be of various types of applications in the entertainment industry.
Thank you, John.
You're welcome.